Hey guys, Adam here, and I'm joined by a near-emptied box of Kleenexes. This is because The Walking Dead has finally returned with the second season of Telltale's heart-wrenching episodic series, beginning with episode 1, titled All That Remains. The focus is back on fan-favorite Clementine, who managed the impressive feat of surviving the first season's grim finale. She was forced to grow up quite a bit in a short amount of time, though this premiere episode of the new season promises a lot more growing up to be had. Clem's about to go through some shit, and you're gonna be with her the whole way. Yay. It starts off with Clem, Krista, and Omid, who all managed to escape Savannah, though not necessarily unscathed. Unfortunately, the merciless reality that is this harsh post-apocalyptic world quickly forces Clem to embark out on her own. The first bits follow Clem as she struggles to survive alone and surrounded by the undead. She goes for a swim, beats a man with a log, and befriends a feral dog, all before meeting a new group of survivors who have taken refuge in a large house in the woods. Unfortunately, a wound on Clem's arm keeps the group from fully trusting her condition, so she's forced to stay in a storage shed out back while they decide what to do with her. Clem being Clem, she decides to go solid snake and take what medical supplies she needs without being seen. This leads to one of the more intense scenes in the episode that had me cringing and watching through squinted eyes. Realizing Clem's a total badass, the group eventually agrees to take her in, though not all of them are happy with it. Thankfully, others are a little more welcoming. That's the gist of this episode, sans any major spoilers. I explained it so you'd have a better idea of what this episode is. It isn't like the first season's finale, which had me sobbing like a bitch baby and clawing at my screen, pleading to Telltale to cure Lee. Instead, All That Remains sets the foundation for an incredibly tense second season that in some small ways has already managed to surpass the first. The characters are still relatively unknown, though this episode does a pretty good job of introducing each as well as his or her motivations. I immediately fell in love with some, like Luke and Pete. I know I won't be getting along with others, like Rebecca, who manages to be a massive, and that's not a joke about her being pregnant, a massive bag of dicks to an 11-year-old.
You shut your fucking mouth.
Others are still too unknown for me to form an opinion on just now, like Alvin and Nick. If you liked making tough decisions in the first season, there are plenty more waiting to be made in this. The point-and-click mechanics have been streamlined a bit to make finding your way around and interacting with the game's still a little too linear environments pretty easy. Unsurprisingly, the sound design, soundtrack, and voice acting are all phenomenal. This is a world you can get easily lost in. I give it an 8.5 out of 10. All That Remains isn't perfect, but it does a remarkable job getting me excited for what's to come. If you've been itching for more Walking Dead, this isn't perfect, but it won't disappoint. Wow, you made it through the video. I honestly don't think even I would have made it this far.
Don't forget to like this video.
And please be sure to comment. I hunger for your words.
And please subscribe.